Good morning everyone, welcome back to the channel. I hope you all are doing good. Today is the day 4 of our adventure. Let me give you a time update. The time is 10 o'clock in the morning right now and we are at Tabo, and right now we are headed towards the monastery that I showed you yesterday. So we're gonna quickly go inside, quickly explore the monastery, and then we're gonna head back towards the bike and we're gonna head towards Tabo. Kaza. So let's go inside, explore the monastery, and I'll give you the update of rest of the itinerary of today in a short while. This is your captain speaking. So this is the new monastery, I believe, the only monastery I would say, and yeah, it looks really beautiful. Coming over here, we have this beautiful structure right in the middle. So this is the structure that I was talking about. This is the new monastery, and over there, that is the old monastery. Alright, so this one is the old monastery, I believe. Let's go over there and explore that place as well. But this one over here is the old monastery inside that. I don't think so I'm gonna be going inside, keeping interest of time. Let's head back from here towards our bikes because we have a long way to travel today. Our destination for today is Kaza, and it is almost 70 odd kilometers from here, from Tabo, and it's gonna take us approximately 4 hours, I believe. So yeah, that is the plan for today. Let's get back on the bike and I'll give you more updates about what all places we have to visit today in a short while. So I'll see you guys in a short while.
Alright boys, so we are all done now. We are done with the exploration of the Tabo Monastery, and now we are headed towards Dhankar Monastery. Now our final destination for today is going to be Kaza only, but there are 2-3 spots that we have to explore in between Kaza, in between the route. First is Dhankar Monastery. Let's see the Google Maps. It is 31 kilometers and it's telling us that it's gonna take us 1 hour 5 minutes. Alright, why is it so much? Any which ways, it's gonna take us approximately 2 hours to reach Dhankar Monastery. We're gonna explore that monastery and then we're gonna start from there towards Pin Valley, towards Kaza actually, but there's a D route that we have to take towards the Pin Valley. And once we are done with the exploration, of the Pin Valley, then we're gonna head towards Kaza. So today's overall ride is going to be approximately 7 odd hours, I believe. 2 hours for this, then 2.5 hours for Pin Valley. And then again another 2 hours for Kaza. So yeah, long day of riding. An update on my ankle is doing well. I had a painkiller last night, so it did work its magic, and the pain is now suppressed. It is much more manageable. I'm able to walk, I'm able to shift gears easily, so that is exactly what I need as of now. Rest of the treatment, I'll get it done when I reach back home in Delhi. But for now, I think if it stays at this position, like if the pain stays at this level, then it's manageable for me. But if it gets worse than this, I hope it does not, fingers crossed. But if it does tend to get a little bit worse, then it will be a pain point and it will be a difficult thing for me. Any which ways, let's not think about that. Let's continue with the ride towards Dhankar Monastery. And yeah, sit back, relax, enjoy the video. Today is the day 4 of our adventure. If you are new to the channel and if you haven't watched the previous videos, then I would highly recommend you to go ahead and watch the other videos. The day 1, 2, 3, I will pin that in the description below, and also I will put that up in the cards so that it is easier for you to find them and watch those videos as well. So yeah, having said that, let's continue with the video. Let's continue with the ride. Sit back, relax, get some popcorn, get some mojito, get some lemonade, whatever you want to drink, and whatever you want to eat.
Try to stay strong and fake a smile until I look away. But I've known you too long, it hurts to watch your blue eyes fade to gray as you fade away. As you fade away.
Yeah, I'm about to fade away. Cause every time I wake up I feel like it's Monday. Something's going wrong with all the chemicals up in my brain. All of a sudden I don't look at anything the same way. Gotta build up of my thoughts sitting in an ashtray. I'm sorry that I'm so inconvenient, okay. Just let me be me and I'll stay out of your way. I can see the way you look at me, I'm such a disgrace. I never really asked to be brought into this place. You wanna love me? Well then baby I have a taste. All the highs and the lows, no, you'll never be the same. I don't really wanna hurt you, but I can't control the pain. If you're sticking by my side, maybe we could be okay. Okay, okay, maybe you could be the change I need today. I promise that I've never felt this way. I really hope that you.
Look at this view, man. Just look at this view. Stiti, you are a beauty. Stiti, you are a beauty. I'm saying this from all of my heart. Stiti, You have all of my heart. If someone would ever ask me that which is the first most loved destination that you have traveled to, the first one would be Stiti. Second would be a tie between Dubai and Ladakh, because those two have a special kind of a place in my heart. Those two places have transformed me in such a way that has brought me over here in life. Now, having said that, I'm not saying that I have reached so far in life, but the transformation process, it begins from a single step, right? And the initial step needs to be taken, and the enunciation happens when you go through something. And for me, Dubai was one of the enunciation steps, and the second was the Ladakh. So yeah, I'm really happy that I got to travel all these places on my bike. Not Dubai, of course, but I'm really happy that I'm able to explore such beautiful places on Earth, on my own bike, on my own terms. And I'm able to document this journey and share it with all of you guys. I hope you are enjoying the ride, because I certainly am. And these kind of rides do not do much justice through GoPro. I would highly recommend you, highly, highly, highly recommend you, if you are ever planning to come to Stiti, I would request you to come by bike. If that is not feasible for you, then I would request you to at least come by car. Do not come by a camper van or something like that. Do not do all those things. Come by your own car. Stop wherever you want to take some pictures. Stop wherever you want to absorb the beauty. Stop wherever you want to absorb this. One thing that I would like to point out, as I'm saying that take your time to absorb, right? You cannot absorb it completely in one go. That is not possible. If there are 10 things to absorb, you can only absorb 6 things in one trip. I'm very, very sure about that, because this place has so much to look around, so much to think about. You can basically ride here or drive here and do introspect at the same time. It is nothing less than a meditation, I would say. At least for me, I can say that, but for you, I'm not really sure. For you, you will have to decide yourself. But for me, it is nothing less than a meditation or therapy or whatever you want to call it. At least in a good sense. So yeah, I'm really happy, really, really grateful that I got this opportunity to explore this place, explore this beautiful, beautiful Stiti Valley and the surrounding towns of Stiti, meet with new people, and yeah, really happy for that. I mean, can you even imagine you're riding your own bike or your own car on such beautiful, beautiful roads, and there's a river flowing by right beside you, and there are tall, tall, big mountains right beside you that makes you wonder how something so huge can stand still, and how something so fluid can flow so effortlessly through all the obstacles in life. I mean, it will tend to get I mean, I could go ahead and talk about this all day long, and it will get a lot more philosophical than I would ever want to, because you're not here to listen to my lecture, right? You're not here to listen to my pravachan, I would say. So yeah, I'm gonna leave you with a good music and good for you. So sit back, relax, enjoy the music.
First of formation and last of dissolution. So this was Dhankar Monastery. One main thing that I got to know over here is that this monastery is again approximately 1100 years old, and Dhankar was the original capital of Spiti originally, but then later it was like changed to Gaza. So that was something that I got to know from the priest over here, or whatever you want to call him. So yeah, monastery was really, really beautiful. We got to explore the inside out, the prayer room, the meditation room, and all other places. So yeah, now we are all set to leave from here towards Gaza and then Pindali. So let's have some lemonade over here, because Dhankar is at a higher elevation level, and when you are at such a higher elevation level, you feel short of breath. So let's have some water, let's have some lemonade, and then we're gonna get geared up, get back on the bike and head towards Pindali and then Gaza. By the way, the sun over here is very harsh. As you are standing underneath the sun rays do tend to pinch you, and you do get tanned up a lot. So there's a lot more tan removal that I have to do once I get back home. But having said that, I'll see you guys in a short while once we are back on the bike and headed towards the Pin Valley and then Gaza. By the way, take a look at this beautiful, beautiful boy. Hi, Pyaru.
Pin ne sir, Pin Village hai, Monastery hai, Pin National Park hai, flowers ka sabse
Simarjit Singh was here at Dhankar Monastery. So if you do visit over here at Dhankar Monastery, then do click a picture with this and tag me on my Instagram. Alright, let's get back on the bike and head towards the road.
I know you told your friend you're not okay, and tell me what's wrong and why you never said you felt that way. Guess you're trying to stay strong and fake a smile until I look away. But I've known you too long, it hurts to watch your blue eyes fade to gray as you fade away, as you fade away.
Yeah, I'm about to fade away, cause every time I wake up I feel like it's Monday. Something's going wrong with all the chemicals up in my brain. All of a sudden I don't look at anything the same way. Gotta build up of my thoughts sitting in an ashtray. I'm sorry that I'm so inconvenient, okay. Just let me be me and I'll stay out of your way. I can see the way you look at me, I'm such a disgrace. I never really asked to be brought into this place. You wanna love me? Well then baby I have a taste. All the highs and the lows, no, you'll never be the same. I don't really wanna hurt you, but I can't control the pain. If you're sticking by my side, maybe we could be okay. Okay, okay, maybe you could be the change I need today. I promise that I've never felt this way. I really hope that you will choose to stay through all the pain.
I know you told your friend you're not okay, and tell me what's wrong and why you never said you felt that way. Try to stay strong and fake a smile until I look away. But I've known you too long, it hurts to watch your blue eyes fade to gray as you fade away.
Alright boys, time for a quick update. Right now we are on the way towards Pin Valley. So take a look at this location. When you come from the Dhankar Monastery towards Gaza, you will come at this junction and there's this bridge over here. If you want to go towards Gaza, you just have to take straight and go towards Gaza. But if you want to go towards Pin Valley, then there's this board that specifically says for Pin Valley you have to take this route. So this route is gonna get us inside the Pin Valley, and it's approximately 30 odd kilometers. So yeah, that is where we have to go. So let's go inside, let's go take this route towards the Pin Valley, and Alright boys, so this is the entrance gate towards Pin Valley. As I just told you, if you are coming towards that route, from that route from which you can see that car is coming, you just have to take a left, and from here you will be entering towards Pin Valley. You will see this gate and it is written welcome to Pin Valley. So let's go inside and explore this place. About Gagan Paji and his friend Amandeep, we are not able to contact them because there is no signal reception over here. So what we have decided is we will go ahead, we will explore Pin Valley, and when we are on the way back towards Kaza from Pin Valley, then whenever we get a signal reception, we will drop them a message so that they know that they have to meet us at Kaza then. So yeah, that is the plan for now. So for now, me and Sumit, we are both headed towards Pin Valley. And one more thing, not many people know about this place. Many people, they come from that, what the Dhankar Monastery was, and they straight away go towards Kaza. So this is obviously a detour of 37 kilometers, so not many people are interested in taking such a long detour on the hills. So yeah, hopefully there is not many people over there and we are able to capture the landscape. But having said that, let's continue with the ride towards Pin Valley, and yeah, let's see what's in store for us. This road towards Pin Valley is complete off-road, so don't expect a smooth ride over here. Well, it is the case with this entire road all the way from all the way from Dhankar Monastery towards Kaza. That is what Sumit has told me. But this road towards Pin Valley is new for both of us. Sumit has never been to Pin Valley and neither have I. So this is a new route for us. So yeah, always welcome a new route, always welcome a detour, always welcome a off-road patch. Snow leopard, Himalayan, ibex, and blue sheep. Alright, let's see what we can spot. Snow leopard, no, definitely not at this point of time. I don't think so. And hopefully not. What are you? रोड तो बनाएंगे ही नहीं ना, क्योंकि ये नॉर्मल रोड छोड़, मतलब ये मतलब टाउन को जोड़ने वाली रोड छोड़ ना. पिन वैली नेशनल पार्क, ये तो बर्फ वाली फोटो आई, इस टाइम तो कुछ भी नहीं आएगी. पार्किंग तो लगी हुई है, मतलब लोग आते हैं. अरे वो तो सारी काजे की तरफ गई है ना. अच्छा, हाँ. ऑलराइट बॉयज, टाइम फॉर अ क्विक अपडेट. We were not aware about the actual Pin Valley, but actually the boat that you saw from where we entered, that is where the Pin Valley actually starts. And from that point onwards, up till the last village over there, that is the Modh village, it is all Pin Valley. So what we have decided right now is that, keeping interest of time, we are not gonna go towards Modh village because the roads towards Kaza are simply sort of similar. They are not very well paved and it's gonna take us quite a lot of efforts and time to reach towards Kaza. And also we are not able to communicate with Gagan Paji and Amandeep. So we're gonna stop over here, take some pictures of the Spin Valley. By the way, if you come in the winter season, you can spot a snow leopard, Tibetan wolf, Himalayan ibex and blue sheep if you are lucky. Having said that, we're gonna take some pictures over here and then we're gonna track back towards the same road and we're gonna head towards Kaza. Also, my bike is running low on fuel, so I do not want to take any chances going towards the Modh village, because if I do not get any fuel, then I will be stranded. So that is something that I'm not keen on doing. So yeah, we're gonna stop over here for the Pin Valley, take some pictures, and we're gonna trail back towards from the same route that we came, the off-road track, and we're gonna head towards Kaza. The roads today, all throughout the journey, are going to be sort of like this only, not at all paved, like total off-road. So yeah, having said that, let's take some pictures and I'll see you guys when we are back on the road towards Kaza. Alright boys, time for a quick update. The time right now is 2:22 in the afternoon and we have exited the Pin Valley. Now we are headed towards Kaza. I just saw a marker back there and it said Kaza is 13 kilometers. So according to my estimation, I think it will take us approximately half an hour or so, maximum 45 minutes to reach Kaza. Because the roads are not that great and there are idiot drivers just like him who want to just pass you and they do not respect other drivers or riders on the road. So that is the scene. But apart from that, the roads are not that great. All the way from the Dhankar Monastery up till Kaza, the roads are just like this, and the roads were even horrible in the Pin Valley. I don't know why Himachal tourism does not invest on roads, because at the end of the day, the major earnings and revenue for Himachal is from tourism itself. Alright, that is a discussion for another day. So for now, we are headed towards Kaza and yeah, so far so good. The sun is shining right above my head and the weather is in the high 20s, I would say, between 15 to 20, I would say, not at all cold. I'm not even wearing a thermal liner, and at night it does tend to get a bit cold, but again it is summers over here as of now, and in winter it is completely covered with snow, and this road that you can see, you will never be able to spot this road in winters. So yeah, that is why winter Spiti is a different kind of adventure. We are doing summer Spiti. Having said that, let's continue with our journey towards Kaza. I am starving. I really do want to eat something because we had our breakfast in the morning at around 8:30 or 9, and right now it's 2 o'clock. So yeah, I am starving. But in any case, roads are starting to get better, I believe. I hope it stays like this for at least a bit of a stretch. But in any case, let's continue towards Kaza. It's not going to take much time for us to reach Kaza, and also my bike is almost like about to come on to reserve. But yeah, not a worry on that front, because Kaza is only 13 kilometers and I will definitely get petrol over there. This is one drawback with my bike, because the fuel tank is only 19.5 liters and the overall range in a full tank is approximately 200 kilometers, 200 plus, but to be on the safer side, I always consider it as, to be on the safer side, I always consider it as a 200. So yeah, overall the landscape is amazing, man. The landscape is, alright, the Plaza is 11 kilometers. I just saw a marker again back there. Talking about the landscape, coming back to that point, the landscape is amazing. No questions asked, no doubts about it. Although we are not able to see much snow as of now because obviously it's summer over here. But in winters, I believe it will be a different scenario. I do wish to come here again sometimes in winter. Maybe not on bike, but maybe on car or a 4x4. We'll see about that. If that is in store for us, then we'll definitely do that. But otherwise, I think Spooky is a beauty. Spooky is definitely a beauty. Alright boys, sit back, relax and enjoy the beautiful scenery. I won't say the beautiful roads as of now, but beautiful scenery, enjoy it, and I'll see you guys in a short while when we are about to reach, or we have reached Plaza.
Alright boys, so we have finally reached Plaza. By looking at the condition of the jacket, you can tell how difficult the road was. It was total off-road. There was only a small patch on which there was tarmac, but apart from that, it was complete off-road. And the decision that we took to go towards Pin Valley, that was again a challenging decision, I would say. The gate that I showed you in the video, that is where the Pin Valley starts from. And from there onwards up till the Mudh village, it's all Pin Valley. But what we thought was Pin Valley would be a specific point on that particular map, but that was not the case. But we were happy that we got to explore Pin Valley, because when Sumit came last time, he did not explore that. But thankfully this time around we got introduced to that place and we were able to explore that place as well. Right now we have checked in into the hotel and it is a beautiful, beautiful stay. Let me give you a walk around, a small walk around of the room, and yeah, here we go. Here's my buddy Sumit, and this is the view from the window, and this is our room. Beautiful, beautiful room. Both of us, Sumit and me, and Gagan Paji and Amandeep, we're gonna be living in this room only. So the room is great. The facility and the owner that we just talked to, he is awesome. And apart from that, my bike is running very low on fuel. But if you're coming to Plaza, you do not have to worry about fuel, because fuel station is here in Plaza. The last fuel station we got was at Nako. Was at Poo. From Poo up till Plaza, there is no fuel station. It is approximately 170 odd kilometers. And you can add like 25 or 30 odd kilometers more if you are exploring Pin Valley. So that is the case. Now the plan is, we are waiting for Gagandeep and Amandeep to come, and when they check in into the hotel, we're gonna get freshen up, and after that we're gonna go towards the market and we're gonna buy postcards. Why? I'm gonna tell you in the next video. There's a special reason why I'm gonna be buying postcards, all of us actually, and I have asked addresses of all of my close friends, and I'm gonna be sending them postcards. The reason why I'm gonna be, and all of us are gonna be sending postcards, is very special, and I will tell you that in the next video. If you do have an idea about that, then do leave a comment down below. Otherwise, wait for the next video and you will be able to know about that. But apart from that, let's wait for the other guys to show up, and after that we're gonna go towards market, and I'm gonna show you about the market as well. I'm gonna take the camera with me. Today my ankle is very healed up very greatly, and I'm able to walk freely, so I'm gonna be going towards the market, and I'm gonna be exploring the market as well. So for now, let me get changed, and after that, when we are headed towards the market, I'll continue with the video right then and there. For you, it's going to be just the next frame or the split second, but for me, it's going to be like 1 or 2 hours. The time right now is 3 o'clock in the evening, and we do have 2 or 3 hours in our hands of the daylight. So it's a good time. And yeah, let's wait for the others. And I'm gonna continue with the vlog when others show up and we are headed towards the market. All right, I'll see you guys in a short while.
Least, I want to thank me.